Now, yesterday, Adelaide United footballer Josh Cavallo posted this very honest video to social media.
Hi, everyone. It's Josh Cavallo here. I'm at my home here in Adelaide. There's something personal that I need to share with everyone. I'm a footballer and I'm gay. Growing up, I always felt the need to hide myself, you know, because I was ashamed. And ashamed I'll never be able to do what I love and be gay. You know, hiding who I truly am to pursue a dream I always wished for as a kid. All I want to do is play football and be treated equally.
Josh, that was so powerful. There were tears in Australia and around the world, athletes, people from all walks of life, every industry and sector. How did it feel to finally put it out into the world?
I can't explain the feeling of emotions. I went to bed last night, I put my head on the pillow and I couldn't take the smile off my face. Like, it's something that has been built up for over 6 years now, and my freedom day was yesterday, and now I feel like all the weight's off my shoulders. So it feels incredible.
Oh, that really is great to say. Like Narelda said, that the story has made headlines around the world, from the US to Europe. My own experience of it is obviously Justin Fashanu, Thomas Hitzelberger once he was retired, Robbie Rogers once he retired. As important as this is, do you hope that one day a person's sexuality won't be as newsworthy as it is?
Definitely. Like, I want to help evolve the game of football. You know, in the normal world, being gay, it's okay. And so why is it not okay to be gay and play football? So I hopefully through my story, I can help change this and help the younger generation or people watching this or who've watched my video that are feeling the same pain to know that it is okay to come out and you don't have to hide yourself. I spent 6 years of my life hiding myself and it was all for nothing. Everyone's welcomed me and given me the biggest hug. So it's been amazing.
Josh, it was so, I mean, it's so beautiful. Like, yeah. I've been watching it over and over, so I'm just thrilled to be able to talk to you right now. Was there any significance with the date of releasing the video and filming the video?
Yeah, definitely. My best friend growing up was my grandfather and he passed away on the 27th. So my number on my jersey is 27 and I thought it was very important for me to do this on the 27th, and it also is my parents' anniversary, so I'm very proud, and that number does mean a lot to me.
That really is fantastic there. What's the reaction been like from your teammates and your clubs and your supporters?
Yeah, the reaction's been phenomenal. When I first told my coaches, Ross and Carl, 6 weeks ago, they wrapped their arms around me and they said, Josh, we still love you for who you are. It doesn't change anything. We just want you to be yourself. And that just, it made me feel so good. And it took so much weight off my shoulders. Just two people knowing. Now that my friends, my peers, my teammates, people around the club and the whole world know, I feel free. It's this feeling of emotion. I can't describe it. It's awesome. I just can't wait to get on the field and finally be free-minded in my head.
Oh, Josh, that's so gorgeous. Because you talked about it being exhausting to have to hide yourself all the time. And, you know, that's why visibility is so important. And I think a lot of people were thinking, oh, you're the first A-League player to come out while you're playing. Like, how is that even possible? It's 2021. But that is a lot of our privilege talking because it's that fear and shame that rides a lot of us to stay in the closet. But to have that visibility that you've now come out and you're saying that you are free, you know, you're a hero.
I just want to be a role model for the future people. And as I said before, the people struggling, like, no one knows what's going on in people's lives, personal life. For me, this is more than football. This is my personal life. At the end of the day, I want to be happy outside of football, and that is being true to myself. So this is something that is on my personal life and something that I want to take with me and show everyone that it's okay to be yourself, even if you don't fit in, even if you are different or whatever culture you believe in. There's always a space for you, and especially in the football community.
It really is great to hear. The A-League season is upon us. How do you reckon Adelaide United are going to go this year?
Oh, we're definitely finishing first, 100%. Like, I'm so excited for this. I was saying to everyone that I'm ready to score hat-tricks. It's like, I don't know, I might be biting off more than I can chew, but we'll see with that.
I can't wait for the A-League season. I'm delighted to get the speech. I think this is fantastic.
Same.
But I hope you guys get hammered this year. I'm not going to lie.
Josh, you would have had messages from around the world. What are people saying to you, and what kind of corners of the globe have you been having messages from?
Yeah, look, it's been phenomenal. Look, I've been trying to keep up as much as I can on my phone, but it's very hard to. I've had sports stars that I've always looked up to growing up. Zlatan Ibrahimovic, PK from Barcelona, Griezmann, who's won a World Cup. It's been phenomenal that they've reached out and said, Josh, we're proud of you. We want to congratulate you. And also clubs like Liverpool, Manchester United and Barcelona and Arsenal. It's phenomenal that they're reaching out to me and thanking me and congratulating me. It really means a lot. I just hope that this is normalised in the future.
Yeah, it's awesome. And very well should be. And this is hopefully one of the biggest first steps for it. You've done so much for people already, Josh. It's really been a pleasure to speak to you today. Josh Cavallo, thank you for your time.
Thank you, guys. It's been a pleasure.